done of these going back almost 2 years now. So it's actually been quite interesting to see how far we've come in a 2 year time period. If you ever want to go back, they're all on our YouTube channel, which I'm going to provide for you today. A couple of house cleaning issues. We do record. I do ask for engagement. I do ask for cameras on. I do ask for questions. I answer questions. Is this anybody's first Zoom rodeo? Are you guys all seasoned vets at this point? Oh, we actually have a Zoom rookie. Look at that. I find it hard to believe, but Shivana, welcome to the world of Zoom. Right? Across the bottom of your Zoom screen, you're actually going to see something that says reactions. So you can use that to raise your hand. Okay, so if you have a question, you can hit the reactions button. Or if you see something that you like, or hear something that you like, you can put a little heart up, right? Or you can put a little exploding happy cornucopia, right? Or you can just raise your hand or clap. That's actually a clap. There you go. Play with it. Test it out. We also have chat. We have a live chat. So I have a couple of my Mark Center tech trainers on the call with us. Some of them are new. Some of them are cagey veterans. And what they will do is they will actually monitor chat. So across the bottom of your screen, you will see a chat dialogue window. Feel free to put your questions in there if you're not comfortable raising your hand, right? And when we see the questions, we'll either answer them directly in chat, or we will get to them at the end, or I will get to them as I'm calling in. Maybe I just haven't gotten there yet during the training session. Does that sound good to everybody? Usually when I ask a question, it means I'm looking for an answer.
Yep, that's good.
There you go. You'll never hear with an opinion or an answer. Okay, that's I hear myself talk enough, believe me. I've gotten better at it, but you know, I prefer if other people engage too. So today is Jumpstart and Command. So it is day one of 5 days of training for you guys, right? Unless your market center does not use DocuSign, then you don't necessarily need to be here on Friday. But the majority of our offices are utilizing now. So we'll see you for the next 5 days. We will cover soup to nuts, command, and DocuSign, right? Contacts, smart plans, opportunities, referrals, getting paid, commissions, designs, websites. We'll cover a lot of those things. So it's best to be here and be engaged. It is a little bit of a workshop, so I will give you time to log in, poke around, do things. And then what I highly recommend you do at the end of the week is schedule time with your Market Center Tech trainer. You all have one except for Kingstown at this point, but if you need help in Kingstown, you can reach out to me, you can reach out to Shirley. Most of the other market centers are currently covered. Oh, maybe if anybody's here in Martinsburg, but you're not alone. You've got people, right? And I'm going to introduce you to those people here on the next screen. So let me jump in. Before we start, let me see a couple of things. What questions do you have going into this week? Or you can throw it in chat. You can say it out loud. Looking for three. What would you like to learn about this week?
I want to learn how to download a contract as a PDF in one file, not as separate pieces.
Okay, we'll cover DocuSign items on Friday. Good to know. Who else is looking for something this week? Hope you're all learning for something.
I'm here for a refresher. That's all.
Refreshers are good. Hey, thanks for bringing that up. We are constantly evolving as a product in the development, right? So coming back to command, on coming back to these training classes, you're more than welcome to come anytime you want. So thanks for coming back. Designs, keep in touch with my database. Perfect. We're going to talk about contacts and smart plans tomorrow, designs on Wednesday. And we're going to give you guys some ideas of how best practices of how to stay in front of your database. We're in a shifting market, and I couldn't think of any more important time to understand how to communicate with the world around you and the people that are in your world, right? How to integrate this in your social media. Okay, we'll cover that with designs a little bit, and each day we'll talk about that. Overall marketing, Facebook, Instagram posts. Yep, that got to go into designs and campaigns. And again, our daily, as well as smart plans too. So fantastic. Great. You guys all learned how to jump into the chat right away. My voice is a little weak today, so I'm going to apologize if I struggle in advance. I'm a little tired. We had a busy week last week. We had a regional training, did some trainings down, spent some time at the beach. It was all work, I assure you. No play, no fun was had whatsoever. But your leadership team was out of town for a couple of days. For everybody else that just jumped in, I see a couple of new blocks and faces, or I don't see faces, I see blocks. So we'll cover this one last time. If you're on this training, I'm David Donaldson, the Regional Technology Director. This is Jumpstarting to Command training. So what I ask of you is that you're here, is that you're here. So Sharon, Sylvia, Ashley, Jade, Carson, Michelle, what we ask is that you turn your cameras on. That's how I know that you guys are keeping up, engaging, and are learning the items that we need you to learn to have successful businesses. Plus, I like seeing everybody's smiling faces. I can't be there with you in your market center, so we're here together. So we'll run with it. Awesome. Lies, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know what you're talking about, Sharon. Nothing but work. Nothing but work. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen. Screen two. I'm going to jump into our slides here. Bonus to have multiple screens, but sometimes it's challenging to have multiple screens. I'll deal with it. Yeah, could roll my navigation bar. A little quick tip, if you're looking to ask a question and you're muted, as you all currently are or should be, you can always just click on your screen and hold your space bar down, and that'll unmute you for a period of time. And then once you let go of your space bar, you'll be muted again. So you don't have to fumble with trying to click and unmute yourself. So I always like to give that to you. So let's go ahead and get into the slideshow today and talk about Jumpstart Command. And it's important to understand first and foremost why. Why do we have our own command platform? Why don't we just have some third party off the shelf product? We know if you've been in the business a while, there are other platforms available. Heck, we've even used some of them, and some of our agents use some of them. But there's a really big question as to why do we build our own, right? There's a lot of time and money and heartache that goes into building a platform for a real estate company. We are now a technology company because we have our own team of developers around the world, but we are real estate centric, right? So why do you think we built our own platform, or are building, because it's not finished, are building our own platform? Who's got an idea? Annabelle, go ahead. I thought I saw you raise your hand. It's a crappy call on me. Anybody have thoughts? Annabelle, I can see you're talking, but I'm not hearing you.
I see simplify on chat.
Simplify, okay. Simplify is a good answer. Yes, we want to simplify and streamline, 100% correct. It's a really bigger reason. Anybody heard of a company? Oh, go ahead.
Yeah. Just, I think that it would bring us ahead of the game for most of, you know, a realty companies. And I think it would, you know, we're leading the way with that. So, I mean, if you're leading the way and you're spearheading anything, you're winning, in my opinion. Obviously there's going to be hiccups along the way, but if you're the first one doing it and like the first one initiating it, then you're able to get rid of those hiccups early on. So when other people jump on, when other realty companies jump on, they are, you know, behind in your head. So in my opinion, obviously there's, you know, things that are beneficial, organization and all that. But I think spearheading anything and can kind of starting that, you are able to be the first, and you always kind of want to be the first. So that's my opinion.
Yeah, that's a great answer, right? And being first, a lot of times, is scary and dangerous, but exciting all at once. I mean, KW has been first in a lot of things, and building their first proprietary platform is certainly another avenue that we've gone down. And there was a very specific reason, and it comes down to you and the consumer. Data is the fight, right? So we've had a lot of competition over the years. We have had companies come into our industry, right? Venture capital, try to disrupt our industry. Companies that were here to help the agent that are now in competitors of the agent. Maybe some of you heard of a company called Zillow, right? They were never meant to be a brokerage, but they are. They were always here to help us advertise our listings, but they take all of our money and sell it to 25 different agents at the same time. And I want to take you back a couple of years in 2010, when I was started with KW in 2009. 2010, we rolled out a platform that was called eEdge. It was a partnership with a company called Market Leader. And it was our database, it was a website, it was actually fantastic and cutting edge for that time period. It was flyers, it was designs, it was newsletters, everything our agents needed and still need. And not long after, they were acquired by a company called Zillow. Okay, so what happened there was Zillow started harvesting things from there, and the product started to die on the vine because we weren't getting support or additional creation that was necessary, but Zillow was getting what they needed. Fast forward a couple of years after that, we were partnering with a company called Dotloop. Now, for those of you that have been with us longer than 4 years, you may be familiar with that, but because we now use DocuSign, Dotloop was acquired by Zillow. So it was the second shot across the bow for Keller Williams. We were legitimately under attack for our data and for the fight for the consumer. Because this venture capital, these companies, what they want to do is they want to squeeze you out. There's a lot of money in real estate. There's a lot of commission dollars at stake. They want to turn our realtor base into showing assistants. That's really what it comes down to. What Dotloop can do now is they have search, they've got listings, they can capture an audience, they can sign them the contracts, they can manage a database, and then they can refer it out to you at a very, very small amount, and they can do all the heavy lifting on the backside. So the fight is us against them, right? It's the professional, right? It's the realtor, it's you against big venture capital and money. So what Gary and the team did at KW was they decided to build their own platform that would be data integrity first and protection for the consumer and protection for our agents and never up for sale. So it's a KW proprietary product. We won't sell it to anybody else. We won't ever sell it to anybody else, right? It's your, and more importantly, it's your data. It's not KW's data. There's a lot of other companies out there that when it comes to their tools, they take your data and they lock down your data if you were to ever leave. Look, sometimes we know the grass is greener on the other side and people got to venture out. We get that. You can always take your information with you. So you can always be comfortable knowing that it's yours, whether you're here, there, or somewhere else. So that's the big why. That's why we're on this journey. That's why we rolled out this platform and this product. Now, the other benefit of that is this. We've got 180,000 agents in the United States and 200,000 worldwide that are starting to use this platform. So the platform gets a lot of live beta testing environment regularly because you guys are getting better with using systems and we're getting better at troubleshooting, production, and development. We enhance and roll out changes, fixes, and updates nearly weekly. So when I tell you this is not finished, probably perpetually never be finished. We continue to take feedback. We call it a platform built by or built for agents by agents. And the thought is you all have feedback. There are labs and tests and groups and suggestions and ideas and tickets and support that you guys are all able to provide that is incredibly valuable information. And KW actually acts on that. And we'll talk more about that as we go forward. But that's the big why. That's why we have Command. And that's why it's KW's proprietary platform and not something that we're buying off the shelf. How does that make you guys feel?
Makes you feel like you're a part of something bigger.
You're a part of something bigger, right? And they're fighting for you. Right? Here's the thing I can tell you to be true. I was fortunate enough a couple of years ago when they were first starting this platform to be in a room with Gary and our former CEO at the time, Josh Teams. And we were talking about this. And there was a lot of concern about why. And actually hearing it from Gary, right, really connected with me. And here's a guy, for all intents and purposes, right, could be retired, could be living on the beach, drinking pina coladas with Jimmy Buffett if he wanted to, but he's spending millions of dollars in technology. We're the largest real estate company in the world. Agents, contacts, volumes, across the board, not even close. So why? He's fighting for you. And here's what I know to be true. And because I've met with enough agents to know that he's fighting the fight for more agents than the agents care about themselves. And that's part of the understanding that the agents need to get to is that, look, y'all have gone out and got your real estate licenses, and I'm going to congratulate you on that. And I don't know if most of you realize this now, but you're an entrepreneur. You own your own business, right? Have you thought of that? Have you thought of yourself as an entrepreneur? If you haven't, you should. You're in business. You're in business for yourself. You're in partnership with KW. You don't work for KW, right? You're an independent contractor. But we're supporting you the best that we can. So take advantage of that and build your business and take action. So that's a lot of this. When we're talking about technology, technology is leverage. It's a tool for you to use to be successful in building your business. I mentioned at the top that there are market center tech trainers. What I have on the screen right here is a list, and I may need a little bit of updating because I have some people transitioning out. But it's an updated list of the market center tech trainers in every market center in the Virginia's region. And that's Virginia and West Virginia. So you'll see your market center, you'll see a market center number, and then you see a name. That name is your market center tech trainer. If you haven't met that person, you will, right? And what I recommend is you take note of that. And at the end of this class, get a one-on-one with them, because they're going to then take your utilization to another level, right? We're going to give you the foundation of the basic everyday utilizations and understanding. And then they're going to help you fill in the gaps, because you won't get everything, and that's okay, through one sitting. But they will strategically allow to work one-on-one with you and grow your business, as will the PC coaches in your market center, some of you that are on PC teams. So good to know who your people are in your market centers. And you'll see some of them, and some of them are here today, and Shirley and Scotty. And I'm not sure if anybody else is on the call at the moment, but that's who I see. So we're going to talk about a couple of platforms. We're not all in one central system yet. We're migrating from. So we're going to talk about profiles in a couple of locations. And one of those is mykw.kw.com. Now, at the end of today, I will give you this slide deck. Feel free to write down, because I know some of us are writers, take screenshots, print screens, I don't care. But at the end of today, I promise you, you will all receive an email with this slide deck and all the links that I'm telling you that you should write down. So don't stress about it if I move too quickly. Is that okay? Fantastic. So now I know that I have multiple screens and most of you might be working on one. Yeah, you can reach out to Shirley or myself or Kingston. It's not a problem. And you know, just go to Drew. Drew knows everything, anyways. That's what he always tells me. I'm just kidding. Drew's my boy. If you minimize the camera screen or the chat room so you are able to work on your desktop, that might be best, because sometimes things get hidden. And I will tell you to log into certain pages because I want you to get the experience of clicking through and doing it. So one other thing I want you to do right now is go to mykw.kw.com. So this is actually the last remnants of what was our eEdge platform, but we do still have some of our setups going on and some of our market center communication. And I'm gonna walk you through here in a second. So we'll talk about how, if you know what your email is, I'll show you where to get that. White pages is basically how to find other agents in KW. And if your office is using the internet calendar, I'll show you where that is too. And that may be one of the few times you actually log into this page, but from day one, you do need to know where that's at. So let's go ahead and do that and log into mykw.kw.com. So you should all see it on my screen. Am I good? Thumbs up. Awesome. So this is what we call mykw.kw.com. You'll see your picture or not. Okay. And then you'll see the word profile. Is everybody here? Can I get thumbs up? All right, so when you're on this page, mykw.kw.com, what I want you to do is click on the word profile that is right next to the box of where your picture would be. And I want you to take a minute and scroll through this page, okay, and start feeding it information. Should have your name, your contact information. When it says home address, don't ever put home address in anything. always use your business address. The last thing you want to do, or as your business address, make sure you put your Market Center address. Even if you work from home, don't put that as your business address. The last thing you want is a consumer accidentally showing up at your house because you put your business address as your home address. Safety first, right? So at the top, you'll see update your agent information. You'll put your picture there. You're going to need a professional headshot. Phones are great. It's a great starter. Apple does a great job. Droid does a better job. That's right. I'm Droid first. And I highly recommend that you get professional pictures. Most of your Market Centers schedule people at different times, but having a headshot in different resolutions, right, work well for you in the different formats for online advertising that you need to have. So that's, as much as I like to have free things in our world, spending $80 to $120 for headshots is worth it. Don't be one of those people that's still using their glamour shot from the 80s. They're out there. I know they are. I see them. They got the boas and everything. Scotty's laughing. You have one of those? Oh, okay. All right. So work through this page. Fill out the information. Your name. You'll see your username. That's what KW will ask for. Don't change your username because that's how you get into your system. But you're going to make note of that. Designations, your address, phone number, office and cell, country, generic stuff. A couple of important things I do want to take notice. One of those will say display URL. This should just be your name, right? Because that's going to give you a subdomain on our KW general website that'll lead to your landing page, your profile page. So don't get funny here. Use your name if you can, right? If you have a common name, use a middle initial. You play with it, but you'll see that you can't use spaces, dashes, and different things. So you might have to get a little bit creative there, but be specific to who you are. Right above that, you have biography, okay? A lot of people get paranoid over telling their story. I'm gonna pause for a second, sharing my screen because I don't see your faces. When it comes to telling your story, remember this. We all started at the same spot when it came to production. Anybody know what that was? Most successful realtor you know. How many transactions did they have when they started?
Zero.
Exactly. So don't let that creep into your mind from a successful business owner that you are, that you can't get to. It's just a matter of time. Time and work, right? Purposeful. Right? We call them going from E to P, entrepreneurial to purposeful. Right? If you work deliberately on your business and you don't treat it like a hobby, you can get to anywhere you want to go. So that biography tells a story for you. And that's an evolving thing, okay? So when it comes to putting your likeness online, you're going to have the ability to use different types of biographies. So what I typically encourage people to do is this. If you or one of us that had a resume at one point in time, there's usually bulleted one-page documents. Take that and turn that into 4 to 6 paragraph story about yourself. And really what you're looking to do is connect. You're looking to connect with somebody. Hobbies, where you're from, what do? What do you enjoy? Okay. Were you a teacher, a firefighter? Were you in the military, right? Connect with somebody. That's what they're looking for. The stats, the numbers, and the production can be added later as your business grows, right? But tell the story of who you are and let them connect with that. And like I said, 4 to 6 paragraphs. Now, depending on where you're putting that information, you may be limited by character count. So what I do encourage you to do is make a strong intro paragraph that might be 4 to 6 sentences, right? So tell me your story in 4 to 6 sentences, and then the rest will be the supporting information to that initial paragraph. Because some websites and some places you can only put limited character counts, right? So that's why I say start long and work backwards. And then third, we have mobile applications, right? So then you got to be able to take that first paragraph and dummy that down to like 156 characters. Because on Twitter, that's basically what you get in your descriptor, right? So if you were ever to look at me on Twitter, it'll say, realtor, hockey dad, chef, golf, right? Because that's who I am in a nutshell, right? It's kind of scary to think that you could summarize yourself in 4 words or less, but that's the game, right? So work backwards from long format to short format, and then you'll have something to place on every avenue online. So that's just a little recommendation that I have for you guys. Any questions on that? Make sense? So that'll be one of the first action steps that I tell you to start working on as the weeks go on. Let's make a note, and that'll be in your homework, your action steps for today. Start working on your bios. All right, start harvesting that data for you. Start thinking and crafting your message. All right, go back to my screen. Social media connections, over time, you'll have more, right? So you're going to want Facebook. Okay, Facebook is still the number one thing. I know there are different platforms that are evolving and being used all the time, Instagram, right? Snapchat, we're seeing different, but still your biggest audience, largest growing audience, social media wise, is on Facebook, and it's a great tool to harvest data from. So you're gonna need to have a Facebook business page. You can't have a business page without a personal page, and you don't wanna do all your business on your personal page. That's why we have a business page. And when we start talking about advertising later and posting things online for your business, it connects through your business page. So you have to have that in order to make that work. Now, I'm not going to teach you in this class how to build a business page. That's something that would take place with your market center tech trainer at the local level. But you can also Google that. They're very easy to do, step-by-step information. Put any languages spoken, because other agents are always looking for agents as well as the consumers that speak multiple languages. And then at the bottom, you're going to see a recovery email and then your everyday usage email, right? So you'll see my KW email is in there. And then I have another email. That's my recovery email. If I ever get locked out, where am I going to send my recovery email to reset my password? So that's why those two are different. So make sure you have that set up there. And then save this information just so it's up to date for you on your profile. Any questions on the profile? Straightforward, fill in the blank, right?
David, Mark, quick question. So there's some fields in here that are not editable. And for specifically the luxury home division, which I just got into with Keller Williams, but it still says no, and I can't change that.
That it just hasn't caught up on the back end of the system yet.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Yeah, there are definitely some things, and you can understand that they just don't want people self-control and saying the things that they aren't.
I agree. So
definitely something to keep an eye on. If it doesn't update, sometimes things have to cycle through. Check with your market center tech trainer, because what they can do is check the office roster and make sure that it's updated within the office roster first, and then it'll sync back through.
Perfect. She's online, so she hears me.
Oh, very good.
Right, Scotty?
And if she's not sure how to do that, she'll ask me, which is all entirely short. Not a problem.
Thank you.
How we roll. All right. So that's the profile portion of that. Secondarily, I'm going to show you what's called your white pages, which is down here at the bottom. And that's just the ability to go in and search for agents, right? By name. Every agent that's with KW, you can search by name in our white pages. So it'll give you their contact information. You can look up offices, you can look up market center information, but more times than not, you're looking up for associate information. So if I was looking for Mark, right? I'll see Mark. And what you see is that profile page that you just filled out. So that's why it's important to have that completely filled out. So that if I'm looking you up, I'm getting information before we ever talk. So it's important to have complete profile information, not just internally, but internally. Oh, Patricia, great. I'm glad you're able to get in. Everywhere and anywhere, okay, that you can put your social, your likeness online, take advantage of that, right? Whether even it's on like realtor.com, houses.com, even the z.com, right? Have complete profiles, photographs, contact information, bios, link backs to social media. They're going to promote your name, right? Because I'm going to challenge you over time to Google yourself, because that's what the consumers are going to do. And don't Google yourself from your computer unless you're doing it from an incognito window, because you don't want to cookie that information. You want to have a real life experience to what the consumers might experience when they're looking you up online. Google other realtors and see what they look like online. right? So you could look at, if you're not sure of all the domains or what websites you should be on, get an idea by looking at other realtors. Sound good? Hey, look, I don't hide. Like, so if I said, hey, look, Google me. Now, if you Google just my name, I won't show because there's a lot of competition for David Donaldson. But if I go David Donaldson KW, right? So I've got my profile page over here on the right. I've got my office website. I've got my KW. I've got my LinkedIn. I've got Facebook. I've got Yelp. I've got some videos that I've done. Realtor.com. So everything on this page is about me. So that's kind of where you want to get to go, is that you want to have as much information online as you possibly can about yourself. So take advantage of those freemiums, or free 99, as my friend Eric likes to say, and leverage those additional tools, because they will boost you for free so people find you online. But you want to make sure that when they find you online, it's accurate. Here's what I find. New agents usually aren't an issue with the information online because there's usually not a lot of it, or they're new enough that their data is all there. If you've been in the business a little while, right? I've been in the business for 16 years now. I have to go back through every now and then and check other platforms that I had used 16 years ago that I may have forgotten about. And I've got different information, contact information, brokerage information, phone numbers. I used to be licensed in Arizona. So you're going to want to clean yourself up every now and then. So again, maybe twice a year, hop online. I have myself set up on what's called a Google Alert, or anytime my name is mentioned online, I get a notice, right? I found out recently that I was incarcerated in Florida. So there are things that you should know about, right? So did you ever play that game, right? Put the date, this man in Florida and your birthday and find all the funny things. Well, apparently at one point in Florida, there's a guy that was me, but not me. Ain't got in trouble. So you should know those things, because if the general public searches you online and your digital twin is doing something else, you need to be able to talk to them. Again, Michelle, I'm glad you found that as great advice. I'm always looking out for you all in best practices. All right. Other thing I want to show you is, where is your KW email? So our KW platform is Gmail. Just so you know, it is a Gmail service. So when you log in your KW to access your email, you're just going to log into Gmail. But at first, you need to know what your email is. So I'm going to make sure you know where your KW email is the first time, in case you don't know it. So if you go to technology, don't click on technology, hover over technology. Okay, people always in a rush. Hover over technology. Go down to KW email. Everybody see that word, KW email? And when you log in, it's going to ask you either manage or set up. Okay. If you're not sure if you have one or not, and you click sign up, it'll say, hey, you have one, and redirect you. Or you can just click manage, and it'll say you don't have one, create one. You'll request an email. I already have one, but if you request it, then you'll see some options. I do recommend that you just use your name. Not world's best realtor, number one Virginia realtor, I'm the greatest. You know, we all know those emails that are out there. And if you want, I'm not trying to offend you. Don't be that person. Okay. And I will be honest again, because I am. My very first Twitter handle was Arizona's Top Realtor. And I got called out and they were right and I changed it. But that's when we fall into some of these traps. Be real, be you. Because people are going to search you by name, right? Now, shorter character counts, you may struggle with some of those things, right? But be true to yourself. So that's your email address, and you could forward that, right? So if you have, this one, we're gonna have this other conversation, stop. So thumbs up, because I know everybody should have one at this point. Does everybody currently have a Gmail or Outlook or some sort of free email that they use every day? Right, we do. Okay, now, for those of you that put your hands up, and you have to put your hands up again, do you use that in your everyday real estate business? Some of you do, and it's okay. But I'm going to challenge you to not do it anymore, because it's not professional, right? You're business owners, right? So having, even if it was daviddonaldson@gmail.com or daviddonaldson@outlook.com, right? Or David Donaldson at LiveWire or AOL or at me, right? They're not, they're free. And that's what they say to the general public, this is freeware. Use your KW one to let them know that you're a professional. You're affiliated with KW. Okay. Now you can forward that. That's what people usually concern. Well, I have all my stuff. You can go into Gmail and forward that. Your Market Center check trainer can help you with forwarding and transitioning. That's a, the struggle is real, and we can help you with that. But at a minimum, start using your KW email address. It lets the people know that you're a professional. Plus, KW at KW.com takes you to a website, takes you to a real estate website. Now, the third level of professional email is having your own branded email, which is something you can do. If you notice that my recovery email said david@revolutionre.net. So KW.com is my business email for training. Revolution at KW or revolutionre.net is my real estate business. Okay. Because I was a team at one point in time. Right. So in order to have your own domain, which you can, and your own email, which you can, it's got to be, you have to have to be a legal entity. Okay. So in order to advertise yourself by anything other than David Donaldson or David Donaldson Realtor, I can't just start calling myself Donaldson Real Estate Group. Right. I can't wake up tomorrow and go, that's what I'm going to be. So therefore I'm going to market myself. You'll get fined, and people have gotten fined. Okay. There's a legal way to going about that. So I'll give you some parameters, and then I will always direct you back to your broker, right? That's why I record these sessions. So people can never say, well, Dave said, well, Dave said, talk to your broker, write that down, right? Tell Shirley, make sure you tell Shannon, Dave was very clear. Talk to your broker. But at the end of the day, it comes down to this. When you look at your license has your name on it. That's who you're allowed to market yourself as. If you're going to create a team, it's got to be you and somebody else, first of all. Then you have to file with Virginia Corporation Commission. Then you have to have an LLC. Then you have to get approval from your market center. Then you have to add it to Richmond and has to be issued to your license to doing business as. It's called a DBA. Once you've done all that, you can market yourself as your custom company. And then you could create a new email. Once you buy a domain name, daviddonaldson.com, okay, I can then turn that into an email through Google to be david@daviddonaldson.com. So there's a process to that. So I just wanted to give you clarity that when it comes to email, free email, no good, no bueno. KW, perfectly great, awesome, good way to go. Third, as you grow your business, you become an entity, you can change that to become a professional email address that's branded to you. Because then what will happen is that email address, that subdomain, will redirect them to your website instead of going to KW's website. So without going down too much of a rabbit hole, I want to give you clarity, but there is importance in structure and planning. Sound good? Questions? All right. So this is your email. You'll see your recovery email again. It's here. And you can reset your password here. If you don't know what your password is, just go and reset it. Okay. And then literally what you would do is you're going to go to log into Google or go to Gmail, right? If I could spell. So you log into Gmail every day. I'm already logged in. But, when you log in, it's going to ask you for your email address, which would be your name at kw.com, and then your password. And you would sync up and put that on your dashboard, and you do the same thing on your phone, right? Sync your emails to your phone. You have to go in, remember on your phones, different phones, you go into Gmail, not mail, right? So that you connect those two different platforms. And then you access your email on the go. So that's it. That's straightforward. It's easy. Just remember, KW email is nothing more than just logging into Google on the go. So that is your Gmail. That is your My KW. Make sure I covered everything there. One other thing that I do that you should do is under technology, if you hover over that again, go down to KWLS. There's just a little checkbox. Oh, they took it down. All right, and we won't do that today. We'll ignore that. All right. So any questions as we walk away from the MyKW page? Okay. And that might be one of the last times you actually log into it. I get it.
Oh, I have a question.
Okay.
I'm so sorry. Oh, under right. profile where under profile where it gives you the option to edit things, it will allow me to change or update everything except for my Virginia license number. Initially, when I joined my brokerage, I was only licensed in Maryland, and now I'm licensed in Virginia, and I cannot add my Virginia license number under my profile. It won't allow me to edit it.
Get that through your MCA.
Okay.
Thank you. There's some things that are locked down that pull from our system, so they want it locked down, and we use this called Winmore. It means it probably just is not yet updated in our Winmore system, so they need that. Good question. And congratulations on getting your additional license.
Thank you. More license, more fees. New agents know that.
And I will tell you this too, just a point of reference, not only more fees there, but you also have to join the boards in those areas to access their DocuSign forms. Just a little heads up. All right, so now we're gonna jump into KW Connect, okay?
Can I ask one question?
What was that, Mark?
Can I ask one question?
Yeah, absolutely.
When you go KWLS again, you were showing that real quick. So I just went in there and I'm part of two market centers. I'm in Virginia and in Florida. So listings at a glance, it shows nothing that I have out here. Where does this data, where does it get populated from? Where does this a manual
just process? On that page, don't worry, we don't enter data on that page. The only thing I wanted you to do on that page is check the box that says list of enabled.
Got it. And that I changed that from Ocala to Leesburg because Leesburg is my primary.
Yeah, just check that. That's all you need to do there. All the listings are going to pull from the MLS directly to KWLS.
Got it. Okay, that's why. It was not showing Leesburg, it was showing Ocala. Great. Okay, no. Thank you.
Fantastic. All right. So we're going to log into the next website is kwconnect.com. Okay. So if you've been in command already, you may see a connect at the top of the page. It's not completely integrated yet. So I do recommend that you get comfortable with kwconnect.com and log in there pretty regularly because KW does amazing amount of training on here that I think you guys need to be able to take advantage of. And I'll show you where that is and how I handle it. All right. So once you go to kwconnect.com, you're going to use your user ID and password. Just remember that user ID and password works on all KW platforms. Okay. My KW, it works on KW Connect. It works on your command and it works on your command mobile app. Does not work on your email because email is Gmail unless you made that password the same on Gmail. All right. So is everybody on kwconnect.com? All right, perfect. So there's a lot here. Can't cover everything, but I'm going to bullet some of the important items for you guys, okay? First thing I want to show you is under tech, where am I going to go? I'll go to calendar first. Calendar. So when you look at the calendar, you can filter your calendar out and see what's going on. Some market centers use this, some don't. Some regions use this, some don't. We're working on utilizing this more specifically for our region. So just knowing that when you go to the calendar, you can sync by market center and by region. There's not a lot of data there, but we're going in this direction. Next to that is the word training. Right? So if you hover over training, there's a Connect Live calendar. This is one that I think is incredibly important, right? So Connect Live is twice a day. It used to be three times a day, but now it's twice a day. Usually twice a day, KW will provide some sort of live training from KWRI from different instructors, right? TLs, OPs, RTTs, MCTTs, MCAs, top producing agents, speaking on a myriad of topics, okay? So what I encourage you all to do as you set your week up, whether you wrap up a Friday and set yourself up for the following week or do it Sunday and getting up for the following week or early Monday, map out your week. What's going on that you need to take care of and what's going on that you should pay attention to? So if you come in here, you can see that, hey, there's schedule goes out 2 weeks or even a little further than that. We're going in July now. And there's all kinds of different topics. And you just can make note that, hey, I want to go to learn about command tips on the pros tomorrow. Now, the times are central time. Remember, we're Easter time, so it's always 1 hour later. And you'll see you can register and say you're going to attend. And then you can get the live stream and you can add it to your calendar. It'll be a live event. You'll be able to engage with the instructors and ask questions and learn from that. Just like we're doing right now, but it's on the regional level. Sometimes you see people you don't know on those regional channels too. Sometimes. Now, if there's a class you wanted to go to and you put it on your calendar and then you let yourself get busy, right? Or you let the consumer wag the tail, right? Then you can always come back to Connect Live on Demand and go back and look at previously recorded sessions that you wanted to see. We usually have the quicker ones up within 48 to 72 hours. The more dynamic stuff may be a little bit further back than that, but they're pretty good about getting most of that information up there in live. But always go through and just ask yourself this when it comes to your calendar. If it was important enough to put the calendar or put the training on your calendar, right? What's more important, saying not right now to a consumer that wants to meet at 1 o'clock tomorrow and maybe ask them to meet at 3 or rescheduling the training? I want to pose that question to you guys to think about that. Most new agents let themselves get run ragged by the consumer's timetable. Business owners manage their schedule. I know associates that only allow certain listing appointment times in their calendar for certain days. So right or wrong to that, I just want you to think about how do you want to be treated and how do you react and recognize that it is okay to have alternate times if you've decided you're busy doing something. Respect your calendar. Manage your calendar. Again, I come from experience. In the beginning, somebody called, I was out. But I learned over time I needed to manage myself a little bit better. So just a recommendation from me. And you'll see Juneteenth, which is actually next Monday, we're closed. KWRI will be closed next Monday in celebration of Juneteenth. All right. So that is the Connect Live calendar. Next to that is a resources hub where we've got information on all kinds of different things. I do recommend you go into the marketing hub and check that out because that's where you will find logos and information about branding. Right in here, the first tile says logos and branding. There's a 33-page document in here that I do recommend that you take a look at. It's not the most, if you're a marketing person, you'll love it. But a lot of agents don't. It's an identity and style guide. And it's important to know this information because when you joined KW, you agreed to use their logos and their branding in a certain way and manner and font type. So don't just start recreating your logo and incorporating KW's information into it because that could get you slapped on the wrist and we don't want that to happen. So this identity and style guide talks about business cards and signs. And as you go to order those things, always check with your local leadership first before you spend money on marketing. I want you that to sit with you and resonate for a minute. Before you go out and spend money, talk to somebody first. It can give you local clarity around rules and regulations that prevent you from getting fined and prevent you from spending money and then spending more money on top of that. I see it happen all the time. You could search by your market center logos here, right? So if I were to search for United, which is my market centers, right? Spell. Right, I can see I can go United and I could download the logos. Every market center has different logos. So if you don't find yours here, ask your market center tech trainer because they probably have it on file somewhere at the market center. Now, next to that is move something. They always move things on me. There it is. You should be at the top. Welcome new associates. I'm hovering over resources. I'm down at the bottom for welcome new associates. Now you're gonna get a lot of new associate training through what we're doing here, but this is another great resource for you to just kind of go in there and see what's going on. What do you need to know about, right? What are the different courses that are available to you, right? Bold, Ignite, KW Connect Live, which we just talked about, MREA, Real Estate Essentials, setting up your account, completing your profile. A lot of things we're talking about, but again, a different way of presentation from KWRI. So welcome new associates at the bottom of resources. Now, if you hover over technology, okay, you'll see Command Your Business. So what KWRI has done is that while our courses are 2 hours a day for 5 days, KWRI has taken these down into more bite-sized pieces. Now, they're not as up-to-date, right? They don't update the videos as regularly as we incorporate new releases into our training, but the fundamental stuff is all there. And you can go into the recorded trainings, right? And as we learn about building our database and smart plans, you can go through here and watch all these different smaller videos that are a little bit more specific and a little bit more bite-sized. So if you want to just come home at the end of the day and pop the cork on a bottle of wine and watch a couple of videos, you can go to something a little bit more specific than necessarily remembering, like, hey, I know Dave was talking about this on Tuesday, but that was 2 hours and he talked about tags. You might be able to jump right to a topic a little bit easier than on my video, right? So again, just a different mindset for a different audience. And I think it's important for you to know where that is. Now, there's a lot of other information in here that you feel free to take the time and probe around. You'll see about communities. Like Mark, you said you're in luxury, so this would be an area for you to access, right? Go into the luxury hub because you can download the branding and utilize the tools that not every agent has access to, right? If you're in the new homes division, soon we'll see a military division on here, right? Different communities that you may belong to will be underneath here. Events, as you'll hear about, family reunion, mega camp, right? We advertise different events. So just get comfortable, focus on the bigger things that I pointed out, but spend some time every now and then and take a look at these things. You have a profile on here. I'm going to come back to that later once we jump into command, but this profile is connected to your command agent profile. So we'll come back to that. Most other things in here, you can just search in a little search bar in here. You can search for people, you can search for training videos, and that's all hosted on this platform. So that is KW Connect. Any questions on that? Awesome. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to jump into command. I'm actually going to log out. I want you to all log into command now. You come to this screen, in your user ID and your password. If you ever forgot your password, you can click forget password. And that'll reset to that reset email account that we set up in the beginning. We're 1 hour in, or just about to be 1 hour in, and here's what I know. I drink a lot of water, maybe some of you drink a lot of coffee, so you might need a 5-minute break to relieve the kidneys and the bladders. So I'm going to pick back up again at 10 o'clock, so you all can do that, and I'll play a little bit of music, and then we'll come back into command. A 5 to 5 minute song. All right, let's get back at it. So a couple things. I put a link into the chat, and it's a little self-promotion for myself, but that's okay. So the area director, Joseph Martin, and I do a podcast every week. So I put the link to the podcast in there for you guys to come check. That's the Spotify link. It is also on Apple if you are an Apple user. And what Joe and I do is we interview business owners each week to talk about, and the name of the podcast is called Entrepreneurial Impact. And we talk about their lives, their backgrounds, what has impacted them for growth, and what have they been able to accomplish, and who and what have they been able to impact. So not just about, hey, yeah, I do 75 units a year and blah, blah, blah. And we really want to try to dig to another level and get a better understanding of what business can be for you and what others are doing. So maybe you find that helpful. I'm having a good time doing it. We're about 8 weeks in. Okay, so before we kick off the second hour, what I need are a couple of ahas. So what were some ahas there from the first hour of training for you guys?
Everybody's shy, I'll go. So real good refresher for me, because a lot of these tools are out here, we forget about them. So unless you really have to think, we always want to just pick up the phone and call somebody real quick. So the good thing is I came over from Berkshire Hathaway at the beginning of the year, and looking at the Keller Williams technology is amazing. So these tips and tools, especially for new ones on the call, is they are at your fingertips 24/7. So, this refresher's already given me a different view on it as well, because I haven't gone there as well. And you've answered a lot of my questions today with KW Connect also. So thank you, David.
Absolutely. Yes, yeah, so much support. And thanks, Mark. And who else? I need one more. I'll take that as two.
I would say that for me, because I'm so new, but email, I mean, I completely agree with you. And my goal, obviously, all of us, our goal is to be professional. I think the email for me, I was assuming that I could just use my like Gmail. And like, it's just good that you clarify that, because, you know, I want to make sure that I present myself in the most professional way, obviously personable, but professional. This is our business. So that's probably my, you know, kind of aha moment.
No, and I appreciate that you gravitated to that, right? Because that's something I started talking to that I still, to this day, I see so many leaders, right, doing the same thing, and it drives me nuts. And I'm like, guys, it's the most simple thing in the world. To
I want to give you on that. Actually, right. I have a real life example that just happened to me last week with one of my newer agents. She was just using her regular, you know, Gmail and amongst other things. And she had thought that she would just get this listing because it was her neighbor, and her neighbor ended up choosing someone else because her neighbor didn't believe that she showed her best foot forward in the way of a professional, you know, real estate agent compared to somebody else. And one of the things that person did mention is the fact that she was just using her personal stuff, that it was like, you know, held to the Redskins type thing at Gmail, which sounds silly, but it gave her a sense of security when the other realtor presented with something else. So just pointing that out there.
Thanks. I mean, that's the real life stuff, right? And you brought up a perfect example of working with friends. And I'm going to tell you guys to get real comfortable with this uncomfortable truth. At some point in your life, if it hasn't happened to you already, and it will, that somebody that you're going to assume, right? Don't ever assume, you make an ass out of you and me, but you're going to assume that's going to do business with you, right? And then they don't. And you're going to be hurt, and you're going to be angry, and you're going to be pissed. Here's what I'll challenge you to do. Just like Shirley brought up, ask why. Where did you fall short? Because I have been there. I've walked into appointments unprepared, assuming it's going to be a come list me, and I didn't leave with the list, right? And then when I asked why, because I did, he brought up things that I do that I just didn't make it a priority to explain, right? So I let myself get wavered away from my marketing plan because it was somebody I knew. So be real with that, okay? And always look to be better. So thanks. That's a great example. Thank you. All right. So we're going to jump into the second half now, and we're going to jump into command. We're going to talk about a little some command setup as well as some other training tips and hacks that I think you guys will get helpful as we kind of work in through the rest of the week. So let's go ahead and start doing that. So I want you all to log into command. All right. So user ID and password, and you should all be seeing my screen. So your screen, is everybody logged in? Digital thumbs up, whatever works for you. Awesome. Your screen's gonna look a little different from mine, right? Because that's by design. So first thing, whenever you log in, you're gonna land on to your home screen, right? So just so you know, if you ever click on the red KW on the top left, it bumps out the applet information. Or if you just hover over the applets, you can kind of see what they are. But I like to pop them out just so you guys can see. You always land on the home screen when you come in. And this home screen always has these widgets. Yours are going to look different till you get intentional and lay out the widgets in a way that makes sense. So you see this customized home on the upper right-hand side? You click on customize home, you get to tell the system, what do you want to see on your dashboard? Right? Tasks, what do I have to do today? Product updates. What's new from KWRI in command that they've done that I should know about? Design updates. What new flyers or advertisements or holidays are going on that the design team has created some cool new graphics for me to get out to my consumers? Database health. We're going to talk more about that in context, but what's your health score look like? And basically just saying, how much are you actually in relationship with the people that are in your database based off of the amount of connections that you have with them? Notepad is a notepad. I think we're all kind of familiar with taking notes. You have a notepad available there to you. Recent leads, new leads. We'll define a lead in the system a little bit differently than most agents may define a lead. All right. For the sake of time, I won't ask this question, but I think that most agents will define a lead as somebody that's going to do business with me. In command, the way that it looks at a lead, they consider it a met or have not met. Right. New contact. In the system, they registered on your app, they registered on your website, they registered in an open house, where you haven't had a two-way conversation with them yet, will get stamped with a lead, a green L button. Or you could put them in the system as a green L button. But once you have a two-way conversation, they're now what we call a contact. They're no longer a lead, okay? If they're going to buy from you, that's actually called an opportunity. We're gonna go into opportunities later. But just for clarification purposes, most agents call lead or a transaction a lead. Command looks at it a little differently. And then last is the activity tracker, which is fantastic, but you all have the ability to hold yourself accountable if you're a solo agent to the goals you set for yourself. How much time should I spend lead generating every day? How many calls did I make today? How many appointments did I go on? Did I write any business? And if you are on a team or running a team, you can track them as the rainmaker and see what your individual associates are doing. Are they doing their daily activities that they should be doing? So that is the activity tracker. So that should be turned on. Now, if you're a solo agent and not on a team, you won't see that ability to turn that on yet until we turn it on under settings, which I will show you here in a minute. But once you check a box, so if I just add my notepad here, you'll see that this box on the right expands. And what you can do is you can drag these around. Whenever you see six dots grouped together, that means you can grab, drag, and move. Okay? That's not just a command thing. That's pretty much internet-based. Six dots means I can click and drag. And you get to set up your display showcase. What order do I want these things in here? Okay? Then once you click apply, it'll reset your home screen. And then whatever order you chose to put things will now show up in that order. You can change it anytime. So play around with it, see what you want your displays. But I've got my tasks here. What do I need to do today? Right? Who do I need to call? Right? These are call contacts. They're all opportunity contacts, right? Are there opportunity tasks that I need to take care of to move a transaction forward? Or are there just people I need to call today? And if we're using the system the right way, it'll start to tell us. And the cool thing is, and we'll look at this in a minute, is that if I have tasks set up here and I have the command app on my phone, these tasks will push through to my phone and I can make my calls and my texts and my emails from my phone. And it records all that activity back to command my desktop. So just something else to know. Database health. We'll talk more tomorrow, but basically, how much in a relationship you are with the people in your database? Do you have their phone number? Do you have their email? Do you have a home address? Click off that real quick, right? Do you have their birthday? Do you have their home anniversary? The more information you have about people, the more in your relationship with people. Straightforward, makes common sense, right? Now, all right, refresh for me. All right, while that's spinning, across the top, you'll see a couple of things. There's a little house, that's a marketplace. Right, so you can go into the marketplace, and that's where some of the advanced features will be that you'll hear from your Market Center Tech Trainer, from KWRI. We integrate with a lot of other platforms through an open API that where they've done a data pledge with us, which basically means this. You know, every time you download an app on your phone and it says, hey, we're stealing all of your information, agree here. Sure, I want that cat face, right? You're giving all your data away, right? Well, KWRI only allows people to access our data or import data that have agreed to not do that to you, right? So the data pledge is that we'll share data with these other platforms if they agree not to steal that data and utilize it for their best practices. So you can go in here and you can search for a whole bunch of different topics. There's a lot of different trainings in here. Your Market Center Tech Trainers will steer you to some things. If you need to integrate for different platforms, right? You can actually sync your phone to command, your Google Contacts to command, your Apple Contacts to command, right? That can all be done through an API connector that you can search for in the back end through a company called API Nation. So like if I just type in Google, what I'll find is my API Nation integration. I don't like the layout on here, so I try not to get too lost. But here's what I'll see, these different, here we go, command contacts and Google contacts. I can sync them together. And where that's really valuable is that as I'm updating information on my phone, say I get a new contact, it'll zap automatically with command. If I update that contact record inside command, it updates the contact onto my phone. So some of these things cost a little bit of money. This is a $10 a month charge because that's a third party fee. It's not a KW. We don't get any money. We just parse data. But that's the marketplace. All right. We go back to the home screen. There's a little bell notification. If you have an alert or an update or a notification, you're going to have that here on your desktop. There'll be a little red dot. We're kind of used to that, right? If you have a notification, it will also show up on your phone under a notification in your command app. We're going to log into that command app here in a minute. Now, next to that, you've got your name, which I'm going to skip for the second, and I'm going to go to the question mark. So for those of you that liked all that additional training, here's more. Guided tours. Teach me about the homepage. Right? And what happens is these purple bubbles pop up. And they explain to you what you're looking at on the screen or what do you need to do to engage with the screen. So you'll see that broken down into different subjects, contacts, smart plans, opportunities, campaigns, consumer. Create your agent website. You know, somebody asked about how to build your agent website. We'll talk about that. They should all already be launched if you use Scott Leroy. If your website's not launched, check with your Market Center Tech Trainer or click on here and then kind of walk you through it. It's a very simple process. So that's the little question mark. Chat with support. You can chat directly with support. I'm going to have another honest question with you guys now, or a conversation. When it comes to support, what typically happens when people go to chat for support, they're not actually asking for support, they're asking for training. It's usually three questions that come up with associates. And I'm not just talking about new agents, I'm just talking about new to command, right? Because we have a lot of associates that are still transitioning. So if you go to the classes, you'll get the answers. If you go to classes and you get training, then you also learn where to get the answers, right? So I challenge you to be a self-advocate, right? That's why I spend a lot of time showing you where to go get answers so that you don't have to wait for answers. if you go to use chat, a lot of times you'll get it's bogged down by others asking how-to questions instead of, hey, this isn't functioning properly questions, right? So that's why it's important to know where my training videos are. It's important to know where you can go to KW Connect and look for those training videos. It's important to go to answers.kw.com, which I'm going to show you in a minute, and know how to research answers. Knowing that you can talk to your Market Center tech trainer and get answers. So that training is usually 80% of the questions we get are training-based. Second 15%, maybe 10, is usually, how do I get command to do this? And that this you're looking for may not be something it does yet. So we don't expect you to understand what it does and doesn't do, because it does a lot. But that's where Market Center Tech Trainer is going to come in handy. They'll be able to, right, tell you that what you're asking is a function that's just not fully developed yet, and is probably on a roadmap somewhere, or they may be able to provide you a best practices or hack to try to accomplish what you're looking to do, right? So that just comes with time and understanding how to use the system and who to ask questions for. And if they don't know right away, because some of them are new, they'll come to me and they'll go to the other Market Center tech trainers. They have a community that they can go to. And there's a lot of great communities on Facebook, and I'll share one. There's a KW, if you look at KW Command, there's agents sharing best practices online right now on Facebook, right? There is a Command Your Conversion, which is lead advertising and drip campaign that's online. It's great to learn from other agents that are doing things. So Facebook is your friend. So Shirley, would you put the links to those two groups in the chat for me, please? The KW Command and Command Your Conversion, and leverage those tools. And the third element that is typically an issue is that it's actually not functioning as intended, okay? Then you need to get help. I will challenge you to, if it's truly not working, always go to your Market Center tech trainer first, right? They're gonna be your first line of defense. And they're either gonna say, hey, this is working, or we're aware this isn't working. We have tickets in on that, or hey, let's take a look. They may hop on Zoom with you. They're gonna ask you for specific questions. A lot of agents don't know how to phrase the questions or explain what their experience going wrong is. I get screenshots, I get questions. Hey, is Command not working? You remember, Command is a pretty in-depth, broad, complex system. So just telling me it's not working doesn't give me a lot of information. So you really want to be as detailed as possible to explain, hey, this is what I'm doing and it's not working. And I'm actually going to give you a little tool to use, right, that I've gotten very comfortable with. And if you write this down, and we'll put this in chat, it's called Loom, LOOM.com, Loom.com. So the Market Center tech trainers, as well as myself, when we respond to a lot of questions, we'll respond with a video, because sometimes it's easier to walk you through what you're trying to do than typing out an answer. And for you, if you download Loom, create an account, it's free. It creates a link. So basically what you're going to do is you're going to record your desktop, and what you do is talk through what you're doing, so we can see in real time what's not functioning, and it'll be easier for us to troubleshoot for you. We can't interpret screenshots. We can't interpret what you typed, but we can interpret better what you're clicking, what you're doing, and actually what you're telling us through video. So, and what that does, it generates a link where we can go watch the video. So you'll send that into your Market Center tech trainer and or maybe to support. And it's a lot easier then to give you quicker response times than having to go back and forth and ask questions, because you'll respond and say, Command's not working. And then you're going to go to an appointment. And then 2 hours later, you're not going to be happy with the answer that I came back with and says, what's not working? Right? So it's going to be very arduous for you. So the more detail you can give up front, the quicker we can respond to your concerns. So there's a loom.com for your, there's mobile, it's on your phone, and it's on your desktop. And I use it all the time. Right? It really is a time saver for your business. And you may find that you like it to do things. Like, I have used it to show clients what the experience is like to sign a digital document. Right? So I use it all the time for different things. So these tools that we give you aren't just in a box to say, hey, this is only for support. It's for anything you need. I've used it for invitations. Hey, I'm having a training tomorrow in Kingstown, and I'm training on shift. I send them my recruits a little an intro video, inviting them to the class. So it's just another thing that you can have at your disposal. But for art, in order to help you, that's the best way for we can help you is more information. All right, so let's go back to sharing screen. Because one of the tools that we talked about that I want to share with you is answers.kw.com. Answers.kw.com. So it's a more detailed. So if KW Connect, if I compared that to something, I would say it's kind of like YouTube, but just for KW because there's so much training videos on there, right? Answers.kw.com, I would say this is our Google. This is just basically Google for all things KW. Because you can go in here and this is your landing screen, right? You've got an Omni box where you can search for a topic, where you can say, hey, I need information on my app, or I need information on command. And when I go to command, it's going to break it down by topic, access, contact, smart plans, opportunities, and the most highest asked questions, usually about setup, right? Or I can go more detailed. And I need something on DocuSign. DocuSign support guide. All right, let's break that down. Or hey, what other topics on DocuSign are there? Right, they show them on the left-hand side, or I can just kind of go to that DocuSign landing pages. And the cool thing is anytime there's something that you could follow a topic or subject, and every time they update an article, you'll receive a notification that, hey, there was an update to this article you were following. This is where you should always go first. Even before you contact your Marketing Center Tech Trainer, you should go here first. Now, if there's actually an outage, that won't necessarily be here. But for help or clarification, always go here first and research your subject. These articles, different where I told you on Connect, the videos aren't as regularly updated. These articles, every time we put out a new release or an update, they are updated. And it'll tell you the last time that article was updated. Today, yesterday, last week, last month. So anytime you click on an article, if I just click on something on command, log into command, which obviously this wouldn't have been updated in a while because that's pretty straightforward. It hasn't changed. You know, say this last updated 3 months ago. Some of them have how-to videos. Most of them are like click-through GIFs. And then other related articles. This is your best friend, answers.kw.com. Now, at the top of that, you see the requests. This is how you would send in a ticket if something's broken. Now, your Marketing Center Tech Trainer will typically walk you through this, but if you want to do it, you can, right? Especially if you've done it before. What's wrong? You put your email address in, the region name, or Virginia's, right? What's the subject? So what's broken? What are you trying to accomplish? Your name, right? And your Marketing Center Tech Trainer may put it on your behalf, so their name may go here. The topic, you know, what's it related to? Campaigns, mobile, compliance, designs, DocuSign, because that's gonna make suggestion articles, support articles. It'll push stuff your way and say, hey, have you tried this? Have you tried that? We're used to that kind of support, right? If you got an error message, then the description, what are you doing? What's it not doing? When did it start? What have you tried to do? And that screen recording URLs. This is where you would put that Loom video. So that Loom video is not a download upload, it's actually a link. So when you record a Loom video, you just copy a link and paste it right in here. And if needed, or if using instead of, screenshots. Once you submit this in, you'll receive a notification, you'll receive a ticket number. And you gotta give them time to respond. Okay, they're not gonna respond within the hour. You'll receive a ticket number that we've received this, and then they will get back to you. If it's a big issue, they may say, we're aware of this, we're taking care of this. But it's always good to have a ticket. I will challenge you, never assume that your experience is the same as everybody else's. Always submit a ticket, even if you think it's a globally related issue. Because one, they'll update you as those changes are being done. Two, they're able to harvest information from different resources because we all use different platforms, whether it's Apple or Droid or different laptops or phones or tablets or whatever we're experiencing it on. Gives them more insight to what may be the root cause of the issue. So don't ever not submit a ticket. There's no reason not to. Fair? All right, awesome. So that is answers.kw.com. and come back out to command. So again, just a couple extra layers, right, of how to get support. Mark said tech trainer, the question mark, the step throughs, the purple bubbles, right? The chat with support at KW University and guided tours. At the bottom, I have post an idea. So post an idea is that second category that we talked about. Hey, I'm trying to get command to do something. And you hear, hey, it doesn't do that yet. So what you can do is go to ideas.kw.com and put in the idea. This is what we would like command to do. This is the functionality that I used to use on a different platform. Or, hey, I see it does this, but I would like it to do that. Or move it. We would like a widget for this. Gary and the development team look at these every Monday. Believe it or not, they look at these every Monday and they see what is the itch factor for our associates. What are they looking for to do? What's next? Some of them are easily adaptable. Some of them are not. So it takes time. But you can always go in here and you can see there's a lot of like video capability and transaction summary page. There's a lot of things that are being voted on. And if they say, hey, this is being planned, right, or this is being worked on. And once you put something in there, you could share the link of that page, right? There's things I voted on. And you could share that with your friends and ask your friends to go in and vote up that subject. So this falls into that built for agents, built by agents that I said at the beginning, because the agents are actually able to provide real-time feedback and enhancements that will be coming down the pipeline. So another overlooked tool that I always like to highlight is ideas.kw.com. All right. Now let's take a look at settings on your page. Actually, before I even do that, let's kind of walk you through a couple of things. Are there questions at this point? We're rolling, doing good. Awesome. All right. So we're back on our homepage, and we talk about command being a platform, right? So you'll hear people say, oh, it's a CRM. It has a CRM. The reason we call it a platform is because it's multi-channeled, right? If you think of your phone as a platform, right, you guys download apps all the time using your phone. So think of command as a platform that we integrate applets, right? When we trademark infringement, right? Applets, that's what we have on the left. So contacts is your CRM, that's an applet. Tasks, your to-do list. It's an applet, right? Smart plans. How are we communicating and engaging with our database automatically? Right? What are we sending out? Referrals. Referrals, we're gonna cover that in a little bit more detail on Friday, but we are the largest referral company in the world, just because we're the largest real estate company in the world, that I can send referrals anywhere that I have a connection or that I can get a connection. Rephrase that. We're in 52 countries now worldwide. You can refer business anywhere, any city, just about any country, right? So think about who's in your world. Because as we talk about contacts tomorrow, I'll challenge you this. A lot of people will always say, hey, I don't have that many people where I live. And I'll be like, great, how many friends do you have on Facebook? I'm like, well, that's different. Is it? Is it? Well, they live in California or Oregon or Germany or Mexico City or Canada, okay? Can I get my mobile app in their hand and get them to search for real estate using my mobile app and such that I know that they're looking at property and then turn around and refer them to an agent in Carlsbad? You're darn right I can. And then not only are they selling that property, maybe they're buying another property, so I get two referrals. So think about your sphere. Think about your database. Think about who you're in relationship with. My last five commission checks are all referral-based. Not selling as much as I used to. My last five commission checks. Just had a client that I sold a house in Arizona when I was licensed in Arizona. They moved to Germany. They had my mobile app in Germany, were searching for properties in Delaware. Bought a property in Delaware from Germany. I got a commission check. Now they're getting their real estate license. So now they're going to be in my download. That's a client that I sold a property to originally back in Arizona 14 years ago. That's relationships. That's staying in touch with people. That's what you can do if you're deliberate. And I hope that's an aha for you. All right. Opportunities is your pipeline. Mark, you're one of the few that I know that are on here that have been in business for a while. Actually, I see Iron looks like, who's got a whiteboard in their office? Anybody? I say John. Right. So think of opportunities as your digital whiteboard. We can replace those, because what happens, and I always use this as my story. It's like you got the girls wear these white blouses, and I happen to see Scotty wearing one today. When you erase the whiteboard, don't you end up getting the markers on your forearm? Right? Those usually end up getting something dirty. So we can replace those. You can go to Costco or Best Buy and get an out-of-box television for next to nothing. Hang that on your wall and have a digital display pulling directly from command with the pipeline. And if you're running a team, think of how much more valuable that is, because now you've got all kinds of different agents on your team utilizing a team digital display. So that's opportunities. Campaigns, whether it's Facebook or Instagram or email campaigns or texting, right? We have the ability to send out campaigns. Reports, right? Tracking. Have you set your goals? If you haven't set your goals yet inside of command, get with your PC coach, get with your team leader, and set your goals inside of command, because the system will only know how well you're doing and if you're achieving your goals, if you told it what your goals were to begin with, right? So under reports, every time I'm streaming live and training, it's a little bit sluggish. Under reports, there's going to be a goal setting moniker. So you can do that when that loads. There we go. Right here, goals. And if you're familiar with KW and read this book, right? Anybody read that book? Anybody done a business clinic? Anybody done their financial model? So your goals are built around answering the questions for the financial model. How much money do you want to make this year? How many appointments do I have to go on to make that much money? How many closings do I have to do to make that much money? What's my average commission? What's my average sales price? Do I do more listings or more buyers? You pump all that in and you build your goals. So I highly recommend that you do that. All right, below reports, we've got designs, which we'll cover on Wednesday, which is your flyers and your brochures and your magazines, your listing and buyer presentations. Listings, we talked about your listings in the system. All your listings are there. Actually, all the listings everywhere are there. Every listing we can pull is in the system. Whether you're a buyer or the seller, it's all there. And consumer, your mobile app, your website, and all those different things. So that's what's in the system, okay? Now, when we scroll across to your name on the upper right-hand side, there's a couple of things that I'm going to want you to do that as we start to wind down here over the next half hour, that will be actionable items for you guys to work on. And we'll work on a little bit each day. Okay. The first thing that you see here is profile. This profile is your agent to agent or referral profile. It is not your consumer facing profile. This is the one that I said would actually connect back to KW Connect. So your story, right? So when you have a story, and we talked about writing your bios earlier, there's a story for the consumer, and then there's a story for the KW associates that don't know you yet, right? Now, when you first start, that story may be one and the same. But the more you're involved with KWRI and the more that you do at the local level in the market center, that story is going to change, because you're going to start to talk about things like Bold or Ignite or ALC or lore and production reports, right? Or communities that you're involved with, military, new homes, business and luxury. And that means something different, Dam and Reunion, Mega Camp, Agent Leadership, to other KW agents than it does in the general public. They're not going to know what you're talking about. So over time, and the longer you're in business, those two profiles will deviate a little bit in the messaging that it is delivering. So that's why you have an agent-to-agent profile and an agent-to-consumer profile. something you should keep thinking about and work on as you do things, update your agent profile. I went through Jumpstart and Command Training, right? I did Ignite, I did Bold, went to the family reunion with the Mega Camp. There are people that are 11 time Bold graduates. There are people that specifically look for those things to pass referrals around. So make sure you update that information. All right, that's really, really important. Now, the second thing on there besides that profile is your consumer facing profile, right? So if this is my agent profile under profile, going to that marketing profile is an extra step, extra two steps actually. Go to settings, okay? Click on that. And then on the left-hand side, as that loads, I'll have a drop-down to go to marketing. And that's where I'm going to want to update my bio. So your action step for tonight would be completing your marketing bio, right? So under Connect Settings, Connect Settings is your marketing profile. So let's pause. Went to your name, we went to Settings, and then we went to marketing, Connect Settings, marketing profile. This is your consumer-based display, okay? You're gonna want a headshot, your Mark Center logo, a bio, your social media pages, right? You're gonna wanna toggle this button on here because this will push through to everything. So you wanna make sure that this green is turned to the right after you're done completing it. Everything is marked as an asterisk that's necessary. Military affiliations is here. So this actually does feed back to the agent consumer or our agent to agent. So if you were active military or reserves or veteran or military spouse, you can advertise that in our own internal system. And other agents like to pass referrals to military spouses or former reservists or military. We can identify you as such in the platform, and this is where you would do that. This will also be added to your public profile in the future. This is your bio. So in the beginning, your bio may be the same as your agent to agent bio, right? But this is your marketing bio. Phone number, contact information, your website address, Market Center logo, brokerage information, your compliance. This will be the same for everybody. Each office is independently owned and operated, right? That'll be on your business cards, your flyers, anything you're branding wise, you got to disclose that because we're all franchised. Social media pages. And if you're Google Analytics tracking ID, I'll tell you this. Our websites are incredibly powerful right now, but still a lot of agents like to track landing pages and different things that they do. However, if you know what Google Analytics IDs are, you're going to place that there. If you don't know what it is, I'm going to tell you not to worry about it. We're going to keep it that simple. If you know what it is, you're going to paste it in there. If you don't know, let's not worry about that right now. All right. So this is definitely something you want to start working on today. And remember, a photo is required. So you're going to have to load a photo in there. Now I'm going to show you the settings page again, because there's a couple things I want you to think and be prepared for as we do some of these classes going forward over the week. You should have DocuSign connected by Friday. If you don't have a DocuSign connected account, I need you to get with your Market Center tech trainer before Friday, if you use DocuSign in your Market Center. If you don't have a Facebook business page, you have to have one created by Wednesday in order for us to do, or in order for you to click through all the design stuff we're going to do in there, right? So that has to happen. Doesn't mean you can't attend the class, you just won't be able to do some of the things, right? So you have to have a Facebook business page. You do want to sync, and I recommend that you do this now, is you would sync your KW Gmail to your platform if you're using it, or if you're using a different Gmail, connect that, right? Because what that does, it syncs all your emails up. Every time I send an email, it syncs it back to my contact card, right? So even if I'm in Gmail and I'm sending an email, it pins that email. Yeah, Trish just said, wow, I saw that. That's why I like my cameras on, right? So it will take your email that you sent and it will attach it to the contact record in command so that you know when the last time was that. Not only did you contact them, but actually has a click through to the email that you sent, right? How many times are you looking for an email that you know you sent somebody? Awesome, right? Lip reading. And you don't know where to find that email. So if it's there, you can click through. So you want to connect your Gmail here. OK, Okay. They'll ask you for your Gmail, email address, and password. If you use Twitter and Facebook, same thing. Just go Twitter, Facebook, and Google. You're going to want to connect those accounts. Okay. Google Calendar, this doesn't really do anything yet, so let's not worry about that. We're Office 365. We're going to talk about emails more on Wednesday, but what you can do here is you can go into Manage Your Email. You can go ahead and click Manage. Okay, you're going to want to put your name in here as the sender name, and then your reply to email should be your KW email or whatever email you're utilizing in your business. Because when you start sending emails from command, automated emails, it doesn't come from your Gmail account. It actually comes from your name, KW UID number, mail.kw.com. So it's not a pretty or branded email. It's not something you're going to put on your email card. But when they respond to that email, it'll respond to the proper email account. And even when they receive it, it'll still say that it's coming from David Donaldson. All right. So don't worry about the email to be hidden behind that. Agents like to trip over things, but that's how we're able to track things. Right. And then you get 5,000 emails a month for free. If you feel that you're going to send more than that, talk to your Marketing Center tech trainer first. I don't think that's quite necessary. I'm going to talk about your marketing plans before you spend any more money. Right? Let's talk about it. I have agents that do that, but let's talk about what your marketing looks like first. If you use MailChimp, you connect that, but you don't need it. Twilio, okay, is something going to encourage you to sign up for. So Twilio is a branded text service. Are you guys familiar with Google Voice? Okay. I have a Google Voice number because I have a 480 number from Arizona that I never got rid of. I moved here. I got a Google Voice number, which was free at the time. So I could have a local 703 number, and that's what it's on my sign writers. Okay. So we have the ability for you to text your consumers directly from command automatically. But you can't do it from your direct phone number yet. Okay. So they would receive a text from a different phone number that you just let them know this is your business texting service, right? People are used to those types of things, but it will allow you to send them things automatically. So I'm going to encourage you to sign up for this. It's cheap. It's anywhere between $3 and $11 a month. Okay. And that gives you a number of credits that are applied to text. And I don't call it text, I call it credits, because depending on the text or the size of the text, depends on how much you get charged, right? Regular text, boom, 160 characters, one credit, so text is a text. If I set an MMS text or a video, right, I get a secondary charge credit. If it's a really, really long video or a long text, essentially you're emailing them, but through text, you could get charged additional credits. So that's just kind of how that breaks down. You can learn information in here by managing your subscription. I do encourage you to set up a forwarding number. What this does, okay, we don't do video messages yet, but you can send a link. Or if you had one already established, right, or embedded. But the system doesn't allow us to send them out directly yet. If you put your forwarding number, so if somebody were to call my text number, it rings to my cell phone. So that's what this call forwarding is. And it charges me 6 credits if somebody calls me. Now, I encourage you, don't hang up on them. Like, hey, I'll call you right back to not get charged the credits. Just take the call, right? It's the cost of doing business. So it's just highly, highly valuable. So it's just on the surface, these are things that you're gonna come across that I do want you, if you have more detailed questions on those things, check out answers.kw.com. These are things that your Marketing Center tech trainer will go in depth with you over in your post follow-up, but definitely something that you will want to utilize in your business. Okay. So a couple more things over the next 15 minutes, but before I walk away from the setup screen, I did see there's a couple of questions that came in. We'll cover DocuSign on Friday. DocuSign is not syncing your clients. If it's a previous DocuSign account, that's actually different. But we'll get into more detail of that on Friday. Would it be best to unforward my KW emails from Gmail? Surely. I'm not sure that she's having breakfast. No, somebody asked a question.
Yeah, Sylvia, if you want to unmute yourself, please, and ask your question so we can understand a little bit better.
Okay, my question was, I've always forwarded my KW emails to my main Gmail account.
Okay.
And I'm trying to remember, it was something we were talking about a few minutes ago about the Gmail. Oh, now that we have, that was before we had the Gmail here through KW.
You can forward your other Gmail account to your KW Gmail if you like.
Okay, I just did it the opposite way because that was before I've been, you know, 14 years. So that was before we actually had it through Gmail. So we had to go through, you know, another section. So should now I can separate them and put it back the way it was.
Yeah.
Am I correct? Okay.
Yeah, you can separate them independently and or, right? Because remember your KW email, like, what were you saying? Do you have a branded email address that you use for your business?
No. This is the one that I've had before we actually were using Gmail. This is years and years and years ago.
Oh, okay.
And I never unforwarded the KW because remember we had to go to another website to pull up all our, you know, information. So I linked it to that years and years ago. But now that we have Gmail, I guess I can unforward it and be able to actually go into my KW through that instead of having it forwarded.
Yes.
All right, because I just wanted to make it a little bit easier because what happens is then when you respond, I have to go through every email address and make sure it's the KW that I'm responding from instead of
my regular just email. Respond from your KW.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Yeah, exactly right. Yeah, you could absolutely forward that or unforward that either way you wanted to go to it. Right, you could even turn around that to KW just in case somebody emails you in that old system. And it would show up in your KW email. And then when you reply to them, you're replying to them from your KW email.
Right. And that was the biggest issue because I always had to make sure this is this coming from me or KW. And I had to go through and, you know, scroll.
It'll be from your KW email.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Absolutely. All right. Any other questions on the setup phase? These different things we were walking through. All right. So what I want to do is I want to spend the next couple minutes. Actually, before I do that, I'm going to give you a couple of links. So we have a Facebook group. It's for our region, for technology. I sent it to one person. I meant to send it to all people. So if you subscribe to this page, we kind of got away from it. We need to get back to it where we'll pop. It's a great place to go, hey, is there a massive outage? We'll put stuff up there, say, hey, things are down, we're working on, right? It's a great way to subscribe to see what's going on. We also have a regional YouTube channel. So all of these classes, and I probably didn't get asked yet, but I guarantee I'll get asked it tomorrow, are recorded and posted, usually within 48 hours, to the playlist for this month. So on that YouTube channel, you subscribe to it, we'll have a playlist for June, and every day we will, or within a day, we'll upload all these trainings. You can always go back and watch them. I guarantee you somebody's going to ask tomorrow, or I'll get an email that says, hey, where can I watch these videos? They're there, I promise. And I have about 2 years worth of training videos go back there. So if you want to see what it was like when we first started, you could actually go to playlists and you can see everything separated by month or all the different trainings that we did. All right, so those are important things to have. Now, what I do want to do, I want to make sure that you guys all have. All right. This is my phone. Has everybody seen my phone? All right, awesome. I want you guys to get your phones out. Okay. Everybody get your phones out. As I mentioned, I use Droid. So I want you to go to your Droid. Now, if you already have your Command app and your KW Real Estate app, you don't need to do this, but it's always good to see if you're not missing an update or anything. But if you don't have your Command app, I want you to download it. So I want you to go into your App Store or your Apple Store and search for KW Command. It's a red app. Well, see, I'm doing an update, so I'll update it. It's a red app with a white KW on it. And you see I'm updating there. So I want you all to make sure you have your command app. Red background with a white KW. Okay? The next app that I want you to have, what you actually will see, actually right below it is, you may see this on Droid, mine pops up here. This white with the red KW, but if you need to search for it, you can. We'll do KW Realty app. We'll update that too. It's white with a red KW. You got to have those two apps. Okay. And they do two completely different things. Okay. I'm going to do the command app first, and then we'll come back to the Realty app. Okay. Did you guys all download those two apps? I want you to go ahead and log in to your command app. What happened here? All right. So you're gonna log in with your user ID and password. Just like you're logging in to command, you log in on your app, okay? And what you're seeing here, which is kind of cool, is a little purple bubble because we released some updates this week. So the purple bubble is telling you that, hey, we've made some updates. Check these out. So on your screen, you see a lot of the same things that you see in your command dashboard, right? What's due today from your tasks, any leads that you've had. Have to do any tour requests, right? That people ask you to see properties, property inquiries, clients that were recently active. Your opportunity dashboard is there. Who's got birthdays in the next 30 days or anniversary, or what was your profit share check last month? It's all on your home screen, right? Well, I have tasks that are due today, right? And I do them. Right. It asked me, well, what happened? Right. Did I call them? When did I call them? Save. That activity will save back to my command desktop. Right. If I needed to call the person, okay, I could call them directly from my phone. Now, when I'm calling people from my phone, this is an important difference. And they're my consumers. And I challenge you to be in the habit of doing this, that you open your command app first, okay? And then call them through here versus just going into my contacts and calling them. Because if I call them through here, oops. Problem with live texting or live screen sharing. There we go. If I call them while my command app is open, it'll record the call to my command record. If I just call them from my phone, it doesn't know that I made a call. So it's an extra step, but it's an extra valuable step. Does that make sense? Same thing with texting. I'm going to text them, open up your command app, choose them from the directory, and text them that way. And then it records the text to your record that you texted them. It's a slight change, but it's an incredibly worthwhile change. So just kind of think of your command app as your contacts list instead of your phone list, okay? And do all the activities, phone calls, text messaging directly from there. Obviously, you want to play around with this. You want to get comfortable with it. This is something we launched a couple of months ago, And it's gotten stronger and stronger and stronger. And there's some actually new things that I'm seeing for the first time. This display board is brand new release. Here's my notifications, right? Things that I have to do, right? I need to do them. Emails that have come in. Most agents that are in the field are going to end up using this more than they're going to use their desktop. That's why it was so important for us to kind of wait to distribute this when we did, and how quickly and rapidly we're making improvements as we get live evaluations from the field, right? So just go in here, you can look at your contacts. I can call my contacts, I can text my contacts, I can email my contacts. I can see who was recently active, right, on my database. You see who are my leads. I can see my different smart views, right? Those, we'll talk about smart views tomorrow. These are different displays that I have saved settings, right? So I can see all of my hockey contacts, right? So anything I can do on my desktop, for the most part, except the writing contracts at this point, I can do most of it here, most of the most important things. Questions on the Command Mobile app? They ask you, if you guys been playing around with this yet, is this the first time you've seen it? Okay. All right, so we leave the Command Mobile app. Now we're going to go into the KW Realty app. Okay. Now there's a distinguishable big difference between these two platforms, okay? And if you're going into the Realty app for the first time, it's going to ask you to create an account. Okay. It doesn't know that you are you. You got to get this really clear in your mind, okay? The real estate app does not look at you as Michelle, Carson, Albert, Mark, David, Annabelle, Tricia as realtors. It looks at you like you are a consumer. It doesn't know that you're a realtor because this is a consumer-driven app. So your login is not your KW user ID. You have to create one. So for clearances in my own mind, I created a dummy account under my son's name instead of my own name with a generic email address that I use for testing purposes, right? So you have to be very clear. It doesn't know that you're you, and you actually need to tell it that your realtor is you. So when you first log in, it's going to ask you to choose a realtor, and you're going to go in, you're going to type in your name. I know it's a little confusing. Remember, this is the consumer experience. It's not the agent experience. So are you guys all logged in or going through the login process right now? Okay. If you've already logged in previously, you may or may not have chosen an agent. So what I want you to do is make sure that you chose the right agent. I've actually had people in my class who they chose me because they were, I don't know exactly how that happened, but I think they accidentally searched for me and put me in when they were playing around with it. But once you're in, if you're already in, you hit the more button. At the top, you should see an agent. If not, it'll say search for agent. Okay, then you type your name in and choose yourself from the dropdown. If you're not showing up on the dropdown, okay, then you may have just joined in the last couple of days and the system hasn't caught up with itself. And I'm going to challenge you to go talk to your Marketing Center Tech Trainer and make sure that your paperwork and everything is up to date on the back end so that you're actually in the system. Okay, so before we go any further into this side of things, does everybody have the app and does everybody see themselves that they're branded to themselves? Yay. All right.
I actually have a question for you, David. So like I said, I'm new and I just recently received my license, but in here, it's showing my like legal name, which is my married name, but I'm going by like my maiden name, just because a lot of my family knows, and you know, that's just my preference. So that's my DBA is my maiden name. So it's actually should be under Michelle Poole. Now it's under my legal name. How do I adjust that?
So it's going to default to however you're in our WIMWR system. If you're in our WISP or whatever's on your license.
Okay.
Right. If your legal name is on your license, then that's what's in our system.
I see.
So you would need to go back and have them update that on the back end, or you may even have to add your other name as a DBA to your license and get that in the system. You can change that under The MCA can update that, and you would also want to update that on your mykw.kw.com profile.
Okay. Do I need to call like DPOR for that or no?
I would check with your broker because I don't know if that's something that they can do directly online or not.
Okay, good to know. Thank you.
Absolutely. Was there another question? I saw a no.
Yes, Nicole is saying she was, I guess she missed where she could choose herself as a realtor, if you don't mind redoing that, David.
Yeah, so once you, if you hit the more button at the bottom of the page, at the top, if you're not already connected to yourself, it'll allow you to select a realtor. You would just type in your name and then you would select yourself. And then it'll save you as that person's realtor, realtor for yourself. I know that's wonky, but that's.
So this is Nicole. So just pushing connect with me makes me my own correct. Realtor. Gotcha. Okay, yeah. Thank you.
And what you will see, believe it or not, is that by doing that, it'll actually create a new contact or a new lead for you inside of command, because it's like somebody new to your world because they don't know you're you.
Gotcha. Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, right below this, I'm going to show you something else. And this will be another one of your actions for today. It says share the app. You've got to get the app in the hands of everybody you know. Everybody. I don't care where they live. And the best way to do this is instant messaging, direct messaging, Facebook Messenger. If you just put it as an email signature, if you just send it out in bulk email, if you just say, hey, download my mobile app, they're not going to do it. So you want to send them a specific message that says, hey, this is Dave. This is my new awesome real estate app. It works wherever you are, right? You're going to love this. And then I always kind of prop it up, especially depending on my relationship with the people, say, hey, listen, I may even say, hey, listen, I got this new tool in my business and I want your opinion. And if you could share with a couple of people and go in there and like some properties and create an account, let me know what you think. Like, because people love engagement, right? So if you have that kind of relationship with some people, you know, spin that way. If it's something you don't know, then you're going to be hit or miss whether they actually download it or not, right? But when you click share the app, it's going to ask you, how do you want to share it, right? It's going to use your own device and say, how would you like to send this out, right? Typically, I can do a Facebook Messenger or Gmail, but typically I do the Messenger, right? And what's going to happen, it's going to generate an automatic text message. Now, remember, the message isn't what's important. It's getting it out, because the message says, I use this app to search for homes with my agent, David Donaldson. I am David Donaldson. So it sounds funny if I text Michelle from myself, the realtor, and says, I'm using David, my realtor, right? That's wonky, right? So you could click right in here and change that message. Now, it doesn't change the default message, because the intention here is for your consumers to share, right? You want that to spider out. So you could actually just go in here and text or type in right in your text and change the message that you're sending. Now, certain phones allow you to create like a hot text where you just copy and paste it. So depending on devices and your links, you can type out a text message and send it. What your most important thing in this text message is this link. That https://kwriapp.link/kw, that KW2QPV2PQ, that's specific to you. So when they click that link and when they download the app, they shouldn't have to choose you as the realtor. It'll automatically brand you as the realtor. So that step that you took to select yourself is bypassed when you share this link directly with them. So customize your message and you just copy and paste it and go one at a time through your phone, or one at a time through your Facebook friends, and you'll be surprised how quickly people will download and use this thing. But you have to be proactive with it. And if you just blurb it out to everybody, then your usage will be lower. That's fair. You get that, right? Personalization, customization, coming from contribution is where you want to be with that. So that's how you share it directly. Now, you can share it directly from there, or you can just copy that link and bypass sharing it directly from the app and just share it directly from your phone, save it on your phone, however that works for you. It's perfectly fine. Okay, now from there, just play around with it, right? So the consumers will probably have a co-buyer, so they could add a co-buyer to their account, right? How do they want to receive notifications, right? What's great about this is once they start utilizing it and they create saved searches, they'll receive live notifications. You can send them listings directly, right? So if there are specific properties that you want them to see, you can actually send that directly to them. I could kind of create what's called a collection and send that to Mark, because those safe searches is what? Three bedrooms, two baths, and 22066, 800 to 1.2 million, and they get everything. But on my side, right, from the desktop, actually, I can go into consumer and collections, and we cover this later, but I can actually say, hey, these five properties meet exactly what my consumer is looking for, and I could send it to them, and it pings them on their phone. That's the difference from safe search and being a proactive realtor, right? I've done the homework. Here's the properties that meet your criteria, not just responding to a safe search link. Okay. They have the ability to get quotes on insurance, mortgage quotes. They have an affordability calculator. This is all great stuff for the consumer, right? And it keeps them on our device. They don't have to go to Google and be like, all right, so what's this property going to cost me? Right. If I'm on a property, so I make that little triangle, it drops to wherever I am. When you or your consumers log in, the first thing you'll see on the screen is wherever your last search was. That's by default, because most consumers, when they're logging back in a second time, want to look at what they were just looking at. And if we just keep moving it as they move, they might forget what they were looking at. So the first thing that when it pops up will always be whatever their last search area was. They could click this current location tab and it'll drop them to where they are. When you're looking at a property, right, the pictures will show up. Your brand will show up, right? Even if it's not your listing, it'll say courtesy of, but your contact information will be here. They could share the app, that listing with other people. They can save it and create a collection. They could toggle through 47 pictures. It's new to the market, or if it was a price change, if there was an open house, that all would all be stamped on there. They could schedule a tour directly with you. When would they like to tour the property? Would it like to be in person or a video tour? We launched that in the middle of COVID because we couldn't have people in the houses. So we were doing video tours for people, right? So this was a quick adaptation that we put in that we just kept. Give them the option in person, right? Or video. I mentioned my consumer from Germany. They did a video tour of the property in Delaware, right? So they can select tour times. They could ask questions of the agent. Remember, even though it's not your listing, but they're branded to you, and they ask a question on the property, you'll get the question. If they download the app and they are not branded to you, and then they ask a question on the property, who does that question go to? Any guesses?
Not us. maybe someone at the top of the list.
I don't know, somebody else.
Listing agent.
It won't go to the listing agent if they're not a KW agent. We're not going to do that, right? It'll go to the closest market center. Okay, so the closest market center will receive a lead for them to share within the market center. If it's a KW listing and they're not branded to you, it'll go to the listing agent. So Michelle, if you have a listing and my consumer is using the KW app, but they didn't brand it to me for whatever reason, and they're interested in a property, you'll get a notification that somebody's interested in your listing. But if they're my client and they're addressed to me and it's your listing, I'll get a notification that I have a client that's interested in your listing. It should be. But no, it doesn't redirect to other companies. We're not going to do that. All right, so all the property details are there. You guys are kind of used to that. Neighborhood information is there. What locals are saying, we pull these from third-party aggregators. I love the drive times in here. Your consumers could actually put in and save up to 3 drive times. And every time they look at drive times against a property, it tells them how far away they are, right? It's not like it's connected to Waze where it's updating in real time, but you're gonna get a general understanding of how far a property is from school or from work or whatever. Nearby schools are all listed there. We pull that information. Remember, source of the source. So it's not coming from us. It's coming from statewide rankings. So that's all there. Tax information is there. HOA information is there. They can do the payment calculator, figure out a cost of the property. They can get a quote for the property. They can get an insurance quote for the property. They can see other nearby homes that are for sale around that property. They can draw on the map. They can create search. They can do safe searches. They can filter. They can change their views, right? They can change the display. They can filter and search by bedrooms and bathrooms. So all the common functions are there. I could change for sale, short sale, foreclosures. I could turn on and off for rents. I want to see those. If I want to see in list view versus, right, this versus map view, I could save properties. I could save search. I could draw. So I do here. I could draw the property, right? Save the boundary, save the property. There's some more advanced features in here. There's a feed. We'll touch on this later for you guys, but they can update where they are in the process. Like, have they been pre-approved? Are they in escrow? That can title, that way they can see where they are during the transaction. That's it right here. What can I afford? Start your search, get pre-approved. And that allows them to communicate with you directly through the app. So we ran 10 minutes long. I apologize for that, but I thought it's important for you guys to have those things. Easy to use, you're right, Shirley. And just an incredible tool. The most important thing is you got to get it out there. You got to be comfortable with it, right? You just got to get it out there.
Hey, David, I know that we might not have time, but do you have yourself as a contact in your command? I just want them to see really quickly how that translates to the timeline.
Yep, you know I do.
Awesome. So Annabelle, I think this will answer your question at a higher level. Yes. One of the reasons why I highly encourage my agents to use our technology is because the visibility that they have and the you know, the information that they can obtain from their clients without necessarily communicating with them, you know, every hour, every single day. So he's going to open up his command and he's going to go to timeline, and everything that he did on the app as the consumer, he'll be able to see in command.
Just a second. I think this is the account. I have a couple accounts. I can't remember if it was this one or another one. Might have been on my other account, but essentially everything shows up here on their timelines.
Yeah, and that's, you know, that's my fault. I put you on the spot. But basically every single neighborhood, every single address, everything that they click on using the app or your website shows up on here in their timeline. Yeah. In live. So if they do it, you immediately get a response. If you're using the command app, it's awesome because the second that they put something on there that they want to, you know, schedule a tour with you, you'll get a notification instantly. So for the client, it's great because you'll be able to see everything on the background and you'll be able to help them a lot better with their needs. It is also very, very easy to use. Does that answer your question, Annabelle? Okay, who's your Market Center tech trainer? Maybe we can follow up with you on that. And we have run out of time, but maybe this is something that we can tie in next time. Kyle, okay. Yeah, he's awesome. So we'll make sure he follows up with you too.
Basically at the end of the day, other activity comes to your timeline, right? And the value there is knowing what they're doing. Mm-hmm. Right? Not stalking, but you're stalking. And knowing what kind of activity they're doing and how much activity they're doing helps you escalate the conversation, right? It makes that communication, puts them at the center of the transaction and makes it very easy to communicate with them. Because what happens in the past is that regardless of what, a lot of them are accustomed to using other tools, and then they send you links, or the data is not as up to date, or you got to start. It's that communication of using everything all at once together streamlines our communication process, right? If they're sending you links from homes.com, you have to try to authenticate and click and look and see if they're actually listed or not, or what's going on. If it's coming from your device and you're seeing this and you're already aware of what's going on in their world, and you know the source of the source. That's the most important thing. It's centralized communication for everything. Now, tomorrow we're going to go into contacts and smart plans. And Ruth is going to train tomorrow. She's another fantastic trainer out of our town center location. As I mentioned and promised you, you guys will get an email to me or from me later today with all the contact and the important information from today's class. Let me just make sure I covered all the important stuff. So all these links will be available to you. You'll have all these. I know a lot of some of you were taking pictures and looking at those things. The layout for the week is contacts and smart plans, design and campaigns, and then opportunities on Thursday. And I'll be back again and I'll do compliance and DocuSign on Friday. So I appreciate you guys sticking with us. We did run a little bit long, but I hope you got a lot of value out of that. You all free to go. And unless there's any other questions or any last minute burning things, I'll be more than happy to answer. All right. Then we'll see you tomorrow morning at 9:00.
Thank you.